Well, hello there, and welcome to Henry Clarke's Band in the Box channel. Actually, not the Band in the Box channel, it's actually Henry's channel. But on this channel, I try to show you guys some tips about how to use Band in the Box from a production perspective. Now, I know I've been gone a while. I've been dipping my toes in the club music, so I've been kind of creating some club music. And in all fairness, right, Band in the Box is not the most optimal solution for that type of music because they use more sounds and things like that. Doesn't make it a bad product, but I've just, like I said, I've been focusing more on club music recently. However, back in 1976, there was a song called Harvest for the World, and it was by the Osley Brothers, right? And what was neat about that song is that it had a great chord push in it. So in this particular episode, what I want to do is I want to show you guys how you can achieve that chord push using the Band in the Box product. So again, this is about pushing chords. That's why you see the title, I'm pushing the chord, right? And I'm only pushing the chords, so pushing the chords up in eighth. But it can really give you a great feel when you do that because it can kind of change the overall feel of the song. So hang with me, and I'm heading over to my console, and I will show you guys how Henry does chord pushing in the Band in the Box product, okay? Hold on a second. Welcome. So I'm back again. So I wanted to do this song, Osley Brothers, Harvest by the World, right? And I wanted to do it because it has some nice pushes in it, right? So this is what the song sounds like. YouTube, don't ding me because I'm only doing this for educational purposes only, right? But this is what the song sounded like originally. Get that push. Don't, don't, don't. I love that push, right? So that's what the song sounded like originally, right? So what did I do, right, is I wanted to do this song in Band in a Box. So I took Band in a Box and, you know me, I dig the chord sheet, right? So I had a chord sheet of it, right? So I went in and I put the chords in Band in a Box. Straight chord, straight Band in the Box, no changes, no nothing. And this is what it sounded like when I first put it into Band in the Box. Let me play it for you really quick. Okay, that's, see, everything's on the beat instead of the drone, right? See that? It's like, yeah, you know, drone. That's not what I want. I wanted drone. I wanted that. Everything is straight. Especially when the vocal comes in. Oh, baby, it's together. Everyone I see. So again, I wanted that feel of the Osley Brothers, and Band in the Box in its native form did not give that to me. The song was in 4/4. I just estimated it at 120 BPM. I don't know. It could be right. It could be wrong. But anyway, I just decided to use 120. And that's what my Band in the Box gave me. So again, I wanted that particular feel of the pushes, right? So how did I achieve that? Well, you achieve that through the chord settings window. And I copied some in to save time, right? So again, so what I did, remember, it sounds like this. Everything is straight on the beat. But that's not the way the song went. That's not what I wanted. So again, so in my chord settings window, I'm going to right click. This was the first push, was this B minor seventh. So I'm going to take it. I'm going to right click. I'm going to go to chord settings. And this is the window here. And I'm going to push that chord up an eighth. And I'm going to click OK. It's put the little carrot over top of it, right? If it was a 16th, it would have put two carrots, right? And the chord turns green. For right now, it's just up an eighth, right? So I took that up an eighth. I took the G major ninth up an eighth, chord settings, push an eighth, okay. I took the E minor, C7th, right click, chord settings, up an eighth, and I took this G here, chord settings, right click, chord settings, up an eighth, there. Did the same here. Chord settings, because this is kind of repetitive, right? Chord settings, and I could have cut and pasted these, but just want to show you how I'm doing it, right? The E ninth, chord settings, right click, chord settings, up an eighth, and that's all I did on. And then when I got to the verse,
I did it here on the B minor seventh, chord settings up an eighth, and I did it on the fourth bar, the E9 chord settings up an eighth, and again the B minor seventh, right click, chord settings up an eighth, and the E minor seventh, chord settings up an eighth. So I did that, and this is what I got when I did that. Hear that? You hear it pushing? That didn't push there, right? Because it's not supposed to. It pushes here. It's pushing. But the drums are pushing also. That's not what I want. I want the drums to be steady. But still, the chords are pushing. And if, so that's exactly what I wanted, right? But I didn't like the drums, of course, because I don't want the drums to push. I want the drums to be steady. But again, if I go back and I look at my chord settings window, it doesn't give me the option of what instruments to choose to eliminate from the chord push. That's okay, though, because I'm going to have to work around that, which is okay. I got to work around it. That's fine, you know. So what did I do? So I created a full template, and I'm just going to change templates to save time. A full template here, and I don't want to save those changes, right? And this is a full template, and you know me, I added extra instruments, right? So notice all of my pushes are throughout here. All of my pushes are here. You notice wherever it's green, and it has a caret over it, it's a push, right? I also added some instruments, right? I love adding. I added an organ. I added some more guitars. Added some more pianos, just to give me a better sound, right? But notice I have the drums muted, because I wanted to make sure that I get the feel of what I was looking for the song. Hear that push? Hear that push? That's what I wanted, right? So again, so I wanted that push, but I want it with straight drums. So that's why I have the drums muted, because if I did not have the drums muted, you would hear the drums pushing, unfortunately. Hear that drums pushing? That's not what I want. So again, so I have the drums muted. So now, this is where it's important that you're doing some of this work in a DAW. I recommend, if you're trying to do anything really cool, musically speaking, right, within Band in the Box, I really think you should use a DAW. I think that, you know, I know they have audio edit and all this kind of stuff, you know, and you can mute and you can change things. But even then, remember, you can change things within the console, but in order to change utility tracks, you have to use the audio edit. Well, that's, for me, that is like way too much trouble. It really is. Plus, I don't know what I want to do. I haven't made my mind up yet exactly how I want the arrangement to go. So that's why I am such a DAW fan when it comes to using this product. Every song I almost have ever done in Band in a Box, I did it in a DAW. I wrote the song in Band in a Box, and I exported it over into a DAW, right? So we're going to do the same thing here, right? So I'm going to take all of my tracks except for my drums, and I'm going to export those over into my DAW. And the way I do that is I'm going to go to audio. I'm going to go to export song as audio file. I'm going to make sure I have one file per track, and I'm going to render. But before I do that, I'm going to create a catalog, right? So I create a catalog called Render 2. I'd already done it before. So I'm just going to take these out of here, right, because we're going to do them over again. So now everything I render is going to go into this folder called Render, right? So when I hit save, it's going to go through and it's going to start rendering all of my tracks. In other words, it's going to render all of my tracks except for what's muted. It does not render what is muted. That's really, really important because I don't want those drums at all. I just want all of the guitars and all of the piano and the organ and everything else that I did when I put this track together. Those are the things that I wanted. So again, it's doing it now. I'm just gonna let it run right. It should only take a couple of minutes. The song's not that long. I only got like what 40 some bars. So this is not a long process here. If I was doing 80, 100 bars, something like that, I probably would have stopped the video and just let it go. But for right now, I think you guys can handle, you know, a couple of minutes of that and a couple of minutes of my yakking. But anyway, that's what it's doing. It's rendering all of the tracks except for the drum track, and I'm going to use those tracks in my DAW. And if you notice in this window here, move it over, those are my tracks. I've got guitar 1, 2, bass, you know, 5, organ, piano 1, piano 2. I have those tracks, right? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and get my original template. Remember the one I made first that I didn't have any changes to, that had the straight chords in it? I'm going to go and get that one. So I'm going to go here, and that was template number 2. And that's the one that had nothing in it, right? Except for, you know, everything was straight and everything was boring, right? But now what I'm going to do with this one here is I am going to mute everything except for the drum track, because that's all I want is the drum track. So I'm going to mute every single thing in here except for that drum track. I don't want anything else in here. I don't have to go through all these utility adjusters. There's nothing there. But anyway, so that's what I'm going to do. So I only want the drum track. So now I'm going to go back again to audio. I'm going to export as an audio file. I'm going to render. And because I'm going to the same folder, I'm going to put the drum track in this folder. So when I hit save, it says that one of the files already exists. I don't care about that file. I can overwrite that file. It doesn't matter. But it's the drum track that I want more than anything. So I'm rendering now. It's going to render the drum track, which is what it's doing. And this is really good. And again, remember, when you render and you go to your DAW, remember that your DAW, that set the BPMs in your DAW to exactly what the BPMs were in your Band in a Box track. And the reason why you want that is because that way everything will line up from a timing perspective. So just keep that in mind. Don't try to have your render track set at 120 BPMs and your DAW set at 110. It'll play, but the timing is going to be off. So again, so now I have all of my tracks and my drums, but now I have my straight drums in here. And that's my straight drums right here. That's what I have in here, right? So again, so I'm going to close this now because I've got my waveforms. I can close this window, and I can close Band in a Box. I'm going to close Band in a Box altogether, and I'm going to open up my Band Lab. Now, I was a Sonar fan for the longest time, but since Band Lab kept pushing, right, I have gone to Band Lab. I was so used to Sonar, which is Cakewalk. Band Lab is Cakewalk, so it was an easy transition. I know people use Pro Tools. People use some of the other DAWs, right? I will never use Real Band. I'm just not a Real Band fan. But another reason why is because one thing I like is I like the fact that if I want to learn something nice or decent or different about Band Lab, if I was to go to YouTube and type in a tutorial about Band Lab, right, I'd find 1,000 things. Whereas when I go and I do Real Band, I find 2 things. You know, and I like the fact that so many people are involved in those other DAWs that I can actually learn some nice tips and tricks that I couldn't learn elsewhere, right? And again, and plus, I'm such an old school guy, you know, as far as DAWs go. And also, remember, a DAW allows me to cut and paste accordingly, right? So now, these are my tracks over here. All the tracks that I have actually dragged, I won't waste time showing you how to drag them, but I've dragged them over into my DAW. So now, this is what it sounds like. Sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? And I mean, I haven't dressed it up or anything. Drop some instruments out.
Love is together. Everyone I see. Half of us are satisfied. Half of us are weak.
not really my key, but it doesn't matter. It's, you can say, they're terrible on that one, right? It doesn't matter, though. And plus, if I really get to, I'm telling you, I can sing this song, but it's just not today. Anyway, that's the flexibility of putting it in a DAW, is that I have all these instruments now. I've got an organ, piano. I've got 5 guitars, another piano, and all of these are in my DAW, and I can kind of play with them and massage them, right? You know, I can cut and paste. Again, I set this intro up so that, because I didn't want the drums in the intro, I didn't want the bass in the intro, right? The organ starts out, this guitar is a piano. You know, and then I bring the drums in just before bar 5. That's what's so cool about it, but because of the fact that I export all waves from start to finish. Because when I do that, now I have some flexibility. Suppose I wanted the drums to come in after the first bar. So I can do that. I can just drag the drums over and have them start earlier. Just that simple. That's what's nice about putting it in a DAW, you know, is that I have that flexibility. I can take and swap parts around. Maybe there's a guitar pass that I like that I might want to move it into the second bar and not have it play in the first bar. I can do all of those things on the fly as ideas coming to me while I'm putting a song together. Because again, I never know how the song is going to end up when I get started, right? So the DAW also helps with my creativity in a lot of ways that it doesn't help before. Whereas if I was doing this within the Band in the Box console, I would have to go in and hit settings and hit bar settings and mute and unmute and fade. I can fade in my DAW by doing something as simple as that. I can fade in my DAW, you know, which is really cool, right? So now I can have the bass gradually come up, you know. See, it's so many more things that I can do. So that's why I'm such a huge fan. But I digress. That's not what this was about. This was about how to do chord pushes within Band in a Box. And you do chord pushes within Band in a Box by highlighting a chord, going to chord settings, pushing the chord either an eighth or a 16th. I didn't think I saw any other options, right? But you can do that, and it can give your music a totally different feel, a totally different flavor. So again, I hope this helps. I got to dip my toe back into the club scene. I'm doing these club tracks right now, but I will be back more into Band in a Box very shortly. But I hope this helped you guys out in putting your songs together, and I will see you next time, okay?